Alright guys, so please stay tuned because I'm be showcasing the giant psychos and this guy. I'm be farming all night to try to unlock it and do the showcase. So please stay tuned, like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what else I should try to showcase, like any of these, and I'll try to get it and do the video for y'all. Thank y'all for watching. Alright guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be doing tips on this game and tricks or whatever, and what I like about the game. Like, the game is very unique. I'm be showing y'all clips while I'm telling y'all about the game, like how you can shoot and like other tower defense. You can't really do that in this game, how unique it is and like how big the maps is. It's just like no other tower defense, and it's kind of great, but it's very hard, but it got flaws too, like how you can't join your friend and it takes forever to join when somebody else is waiting right there. And then if you waiting, like you can't even go to a VIP server and just you and your friend. So you got to wait. But yeah, since I said a flaw or whatever, but let me get into tips, because like never place your units too far away from each other, because it'd be hard to run across the map because the map's so big. And you can't really get to your units in time. So you should like kind of have them close enough where you could just keep upgrading, but not too close and not too far. Unless you got like a car unit or like range. Another thing I want to talk about is like how later in the rounds your guns get weak. Like, isn't it like the crossbow just get garbage later in the round? So I'm like, they should add like a gun shop or something that'll be good for the game, because later in the round the guns don't be useful no more. Oh, and I also love how you could just walk and interact with most of everything on the map. Alright guys, but it is this weird glitch, like when you reset in game, it is this funny thing in game, like when you shoot the gun and run, it make you do like this weird run thing. Like co-op mode is better to do with a friend or like family member that like know what they're doing, you can explain to them. And solo is the best mode for grinding coins because you can make it farther, because co-op is actually very, very hard. But if you do want to do co-op mode because it's very fun, I recommend doing it with a friend or family member. Alright, but I do want to talk about the graphics, because these graphics is very good. Alright, the coins do take forever to grind. I ain't gonna lie about that. Wish it was like a 4-player, because I got a lot of family members and they be wanting to play with me, and I can't do it because there's only 2 people that could play at a time. It would be nice to have a choice if you want to skip or not, because the units do get stacked up on here. I mean, the game update weekly. The goofy animations while the zombie eyeballs move. The units in this game only attack enemies that's in the front, which is annoying. This game do have this little invisible mode where you only could just watch and don't have to do none, which is cool. The prices for these units are crazy, for real, for real. No matter how low you get the boss health or whatever, it still takes the same amount of damage. That's crazy. Sneak peek, but I love how the when you max them out, the final unit look. The units tech too slow, which make it harder to get a win when you doing solo. Like, man, you can stack the skulls on top of each other. I don't recommend it, but it is fun to do. But it's kind of hard to get it focused. But yeah, this is a fun little trick that I like to use. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I hope y'all really enjoyed the video. I want to thank my family because they be helping me with these games and helping me grind. So yeah, but hopefully y'all enjoy. See y'all next video. Stay tuned because I'm going to be doing the showcase next video.